Merry Christmas. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Yes, we can do that. We can say that because this is what Christmas is about. Welcome one and all as we gather to remind ourselves of this gift that came to us, the birth of the Son of God, Jesus Christ. Welcome one and all in worship here in this space. Hopefully you have your bulletins. You can follow along there. Otherwise, up on the screens, up above. For those of you joining us online, welcome. And you have all the stuff online. But also, if you're joining us for communion, make sure you have those elements handy as well as we gather to remind ourselves of the light of the world that is to come. And so welcome one and all as we gather. And so, as we've been dashing through the sand and everything else, trying to get ready, you know, it's the most time of the year. Let's take a moment and remind ourselves of why this year, why this time is a holiday and why it is special and important. So I invite you to rise and let's sing it. O come, all you faithful.
Thank you.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who sends the word with angels, who has made flesh among all peoples, and who breathes peace on all the earth. Amen. In Christ we are bold to name our sin and cry out for peace. Holy God, we confess our sin before you. We replace compassion with competition. We seek what is mighty while ignoring the meek. We are quick to anger but slow to forgive. We have not put on love in harmony with you. Wrap us in the grace of your powerful word and all our hearts with your peace, that all we do in word or deed may reflect your love born among us. Amen. I bring you good news of great joy for all people. God has come among us in the child born of Mary, Christ the Lord. In Christ, your sins are forgiven and you are clothed in peace. Amen. Christ is born. Alleluia, alleluia. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Lord be with you. Let us join our hearts in prayer. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
The first reading is from the 9th chapter of Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Word of God, word of life.
Our gospel for this evening is the familiar gospel that comes to us from the second chapter of the gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise you. Please be seated. I read somewhere that the actual inspiration for Silent Night was when Joseph forgot to call ahead and make reservations at the inn. How are you doing, dear? Fine. Yeah. You know, a lot of people are worried about rising costs on different things. There's a little bit of Santa's overhead we don't have to worry about. His parking fees haven't gone up. It's on the house. Here's your childish one. What is a dinosaur's least favorite reindeer? Comet. How does good King Wenceslas like his pizza? This one requires you to know that old hymn. Deep pan, crisp and even. And for all of those who got to sit through all of these horrible jokes once before, I'll throw in a new one. Just for fun, one night a Viking called Rudolph the Red was looking out of his window when he suddenly said, It's going to rain. His wife asked, How do you know? Because Rudolph the Red knows rain, dear. And everybody who heard the other jokes before said, You didn't even have to do them again, but that's okay. Yes, we had rain today. Wasn't that nice? Isn't that lovely? We can actually cheer for rain. It's one of the few places in the world I've ever been in that people went, Hey, it's raining here. You know, but we need rain, even though it messes things up from time to time. So, is everybody ready for tomorrow? Everything set? Because by now it's too late, you know. All of the preparations, all the organizing, all the everything. It's showtime. You've been dashing through the sand. Hopefully everything's set. You know, as a colleague friend of mine said, it's the most time of the year. You can fill in your own words to fill in that blank however you wish. And it can be just so much going on. And on top of it all, it's been an exciting 18 months, hasn't it? Isn't it nice that we got it all behind us? Oh, here it comes again. Here we go again. It's like, okay, are we ever going to be done with some of these things? There's these things that keep going on, and it's just this and that and all this other stuff. You know, when is it ever going to end? Have you ever stopped and realized that if we're honest, it never has ended? There's always something going on. There always has been. There's always something going on. Sometimes, due to the joy of age, you might forget certain things, and you can look back and go, oh, those were the good old days. Nostalgia is a wonderful thing sometimes. But oftentimes, you're like, how did we ever get through some of the things? You know, I'll be honest, a group of my friends from high school, when we all turned 40, we got together for a dinner and we all looked at each other and said, wow, we survived. How did that happen? Have you ever stopped and looked back over your life and wondered how you got to where you were? Much less how you might have, if you're honest with yourself, survived? Well, one thing to be aware of is the fact that your success rate so far is 100%. Keep that in mind. But how often do we just kind of get through something and we're like, okay. Or we don't even think about it because we're into something else. And how often do we just kind of go, oh, is it ever going to end? Pastor, this is Christmas Eve. It's all supposed to be about joy and wonder and everything else like that. What's going on? Do we realize the fact that 2,000 years ago, in a time of oppression and occupation, in a time when a married couple had to travel for several days while the woman was 9 months pregnant and find no place to go at the end, that this is the story we're celebrating tonight? In the midst of all of that? And then realize the fact that into all of this world that was 2,000 years ago, that is very much like today, the Son of God was born and placed in a manger. His first bed was unchewed cattle feed. The eau de parfum of the room was sheep droppings and oxen patties. Not the castle, not the capital, not, but that. You think he's trying to make a point? That these two nobodies were responsible for the care of the Son of God in a town that would best be called, grain silo? That's what Bethlehem basically means. It's bread house. They couldn't even find a place to stay. And here's God. Right there. In the midst of all of that literal muck, God enters into the world as an infant. The glory that shone was not the glory of the delivery, it was the angels. The most fragile, vulnerable creature on the face of the earth, the Son of God enters in. For you, for me, for this world. Think about that. That into this situation, God comes and entrusts it. So if you're ever in a situation in your life when you're not entirely sure how you could get any further away from God, remember this. Oh yeah, and remember that. When you ever think that there is a way in which you are just too far gone, the next time you step in it, please realize that the Son of God, Jesus, slept next to it. The next time things are not going the way you want them to, and things are not fulfilling as you'd wish, and things are not happening as you would hope, just remember a child that was born and laid in a feed trough because there was no other place to go. And he came for you. And for this world. So that maybe, just maybe, we realize that there is no place that God will not go. There is no place that God cannot be. That the presence and the gift of God is yours regardless, because it's not about who you are, it's about whose you are. And God says, you're mine. And I'm here. I'm here for you. Emmanuel, God with us. That's what it means. God is now with us in surprising ways. That no matter where you are or how you are, there is God there. You wonder how you got through some of the things in life? You know, there's a phrase that's very popular. God will never give you more than you can handle. Have you ever heard that? Please dump it. Because the reality is, God doesn't give you what you think you've got. God is there with you to help you handle it. That's what God is about. God comes to be with us, not to give us that kind of stuff. That's where we can start realizing, out of this gift of love, out of this gift of grace, we might find hope. We might actually find peace. We find hope because here he comes and entrusts himself as a child to us. It's said that the birth of every new child is another sign that God hasn't given up on the world. There's more to come. And that when we're in his presence, that no matter what may come, we know we're not alone. We know that it is possible to survive. We know that there is life and there's new life, because the gift that we celebrate at Christmas is the fact that life is important. Life is the center point of what God is about. Why else did he come? And that means your life is important. And the life of the others. For God so loved the world that he came. You know that sign that gets held up in end zones and behind baskets, you know, John 3:16? What that's supposed to say is, God so loved the world, he gave his only son. That means Christmas. But it also means Easter. It means that God has come to be with us, to be among us, because it's important to be with us no matter what. And we might go, well, wait a minute, but Pastor, there's this cross thingy here. How important is life to it if Jesus did that? Because it reminds us of the fact that the worst that can happen is never the last thing that can happen. That there is a thing called new life, and it is yours. So all of those other times in life when you look back and you realize, wow, did you really just go flat on your face? And then how the heck did you get up the next time? So no matter what, there's that gift of hope. And maybe, just maybe, if we realize that we are truly in the presence of God, that God is with us, Emmanuel is with us, and that there is nothing that can separate us, not even death, maybe that gives us a reason for joy. We can deal with the present difficulties because we realize that they're not the last thing. They're not the end thing. We can celebrate the fact that we are together, that we have this love that never goes away. We all know presents are meant to be used, right? All the things you've run around shopping and doing and wrapping and all that kind of fun stuff, you want people to use them, right? I mean, there's sometimes we just buy frippery for the sake of frippery. I know that. I've done it myself because, ooh, that was sparkly. Let's face it, a gift is meant to be used. This gift is meant to be used. This gift is meant to be used as that source of hope and love and joy and grace. This gift is meant to be taken and used because he is with us. And so hopefully, maybe, work with me here on this, maybe we can receive these gifts, this gift that we receive in Jesus Christ and all that comes with it, and maybe, just maybe, we can use them. When you're not entirely sure how you can forgive someone, that you can try again, that you can love, you can hope, you can find peace, you maybe find joy. Maybe we realize the fact that it's already here with us. It's not about something we got to go attain or do or achieve. It's here. It came. And maybe we can look around and see it. And maybe then we can use it. And hopefully, maybe, just this is a hope of mine, for more than 12 days. Take something that's just like the Christmas spirit and realize that this gift is 365 days. Maybe that'll change how we treat one another, how we'll look at the world, how we'll look at ourselves. Because you might realize just how loved you are and how loved they are. And the hope that God has in all of us, because he came for you, he came for me. So let's take this gift and let's run with it. And remember that God loves you, and so do I. Amen.
Join me as we confess the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death, buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in unblaming glory with the living and the dead, and his kingdom shall have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Joining our voices with the heavenly hosts and all of your children throughout time and space, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Love proclaims that a Savior has been born to us. Inspire your church throughout the world to proclaim the good news of Jesus' birth in word and deed, so that all may see the salvation, hope, and new life that comes. Hear us, O God. Your love is great. Love whispers to a weary world that the time for rest and restoration has come. Strengthen us as we seek to find ways to restore and to rebuild, to care for creation and for ourselves in ways that are sustainable. Hear us, O God. Your love is great. Love cries to a warring world that the time for peace is at hand. Direct those in power who make decisions on behalf of others that they may nurture and sustain all that is healthy, good, and holy. Hear us, O God. Mercy is great. Love sings through the wails of a newborn baby. Respond to all who cry out in pain, despair, or need this night, especially those that are on our hearts and minds right now. Bring comfort to those for whom separation, loss makes the Christmas season especially difficult. Hear us, O God. Your love is great. Love murmurs words of comfort to a newborn child and bless new and expectant parents or caregivers, but especially bless those who are alone or afraid this night. Pour out your love upon families of every kind. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God's ever-present love is proclaimed to the faithful who came before us. We give you thanks for all of those who let that love show, who showed us that gift that we celebrate at Christmas. Hear us, O God. Your love is great. Rejoicing in your word made flesh among us, we commend all these prayers to you, confident of your grace and love made known to us. In Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. May the gift of peace from the Christ child be with you all. Please find some ways to share the peace of Christ now and going forward. Peace be with you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gracious God, your word made flesh brings harmony to the earth. For we offer ourselves and these our gifts. Prepare us to receive the grace and truth you offer at this table, and renew us in the song of your salvation. In Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
As we come to this time, we start preparing for communion. For those of you in this space, at the appropriate time, you'll be invited to come forward. There'll be two lines coming down the center aisle. We just invite you to extend your hands out open so a wafer can be placed into them. We have gluten-free wafers for those who need them. Just let us know as you come forward. And then you turn to either side. There's a table to either side over here that has, and then the communion assistant will have put out a cup of grape juice or a cup of wine for you to take. There's little baskets over there for the empties. You will also find baskets of candles and boxes of glow sticks if you're one of those people that shouldn't be trusted with an open flame. Please take those and head back to your seats. Don't do anything with them. We will give you instructions later on at the appropriate time. For, you know, if you wish, over to the far right, my far right, on the other side of the Christmas tree, there is a space for prayer. You can light candles and stuff like that. There's not a big space, so please be mindful of other people who'd like to do it after communion. For those of you joining us online, this is the time to make sure you got your items out there. Simple plate, simple cup, bread, crackers, wine, grape juice, simple stuff. Jesus took the simple stuff off of a banquet table to remind us of what he could do with simple stuff, like us. And remember that he is in our midst. Okay, so that's how we're going to do it. Let's remind ourselves of why. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy God, creator of all and source of life, at the birth of time, your word brought light into the world. In the fullness of time, you sent your word, born of Mary, to shine in our darkness and to make us your daughters and sons. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, blessed it, gave thanks, and gave it for us to eat, saying, "Take and eat, all of you. This is my body. It's broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup. After giving thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "Take and drink. This cup contains the blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his birth and life among us, his death and resurrection, we await his coming again with all things will be restored in him. By your Spirit, bless us and this bread and cup, that held and nourished by you, may we live as your children, shining with the light of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, through the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Remember us in your kingdom, gathered around the table by the Holy Spirit. Let us pray as Jesus teaches. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. In Christ's manger, at Christ's table, come see what God makes known for you. I invite the congregation to be seated and my communion assistants to come forward and take their places. For those of you joining us at home, this would be a good time to take, to give and receive if you have someone there, take turns. But as always, we are all gathered here in this time, remembering most importantly, Emmanuel, God is with us. And we celebrate that as the body of Christ. So for all of us, the body of Christ broken for you, the blood of Christ shed for you, take and eat, take and drink, this gift given for you.
shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and sorrow pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, or hear the angel voices, O night divine, O night when Christ was born. O night divine, O night divine. Led by the light of faith serenely beaming, with glowing heart by his cradle we stand. So led by light of a star sweetly gleaming, here came the wise men from the Orient land. The King of Kings lay thus in lowly manger, in all our trials born to be our friend. He knows our need. He guards us from all danger. Behold your King. Truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. With hymns of joy in grateful chorus raising, let every heart adore his holy name. Christ the Lord, with saint and seraph praising his power and glory evermore proclaim his power.
May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, strengthen us and keep us in his grace. Amen.
We thank you, wondrous Father, Jesus, God with us in these gifts of bread and wine. As we have shared this feast of love, strengthen us to share your love with all the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
As we prepare to sing Silent Night and Light, if you're one of those that grabbed a glow stick, go ahead and crack it and shake it. But a reminder as we do this, that whoever, as we pass the light to one another, that the lit candle stays upright and the unlit candle gets tipped. Otherwise, we get wax on, wax off. Okay? So just please remember to do that, and the two of us will come down and we'll light, and we invite you to pass the light along. Oops. I'm trying to put it out. All right. Sorry. All right. The God of hope, fill us with all joy and peace in believing, so that we may abound in hope. By the power of the Holy Spirit, through Christ Jesus, the Word made flesh. Amen.
Christ is risen, is born. Play peace to God, people on earth. Go in peace, rejoice in Christ our Savior. Thanks be to God.
There may be some still out there. There was a box that had some crosses in them that were made out of saguaro hearts. If any of them are left and you're interested in taking them, please, they are a gift. There will be a box in the back, basket in the back for the candles. Please be careful extinguishing them. And most importantly, Merry Christmas.